recently on a flight from Hawaii to Los Angeles. The passengers were surprised when one of their number got up from his seat and began pacing up and down the aisles, and he was reading his Bible very loudly. The other passengers in the flight crew were not able to get the man to sit down and be quiet, and so they subdued the man and duct taped him to his seat. When the plane landed, Los Angeles police officers took the man into custody. That was the strangest story I believe I've ever read. And I wondered what had gotten into the man. But I also wondered what had gotten into the other passengers and the crew on that plane. How much does it hurt to hear the word of God? But what I wondered about the passenger, I wondered if he was afraid of flying or if he had suffered some emotional trauma prior to the trip. Obviously, he was very upset, and he took his comfort from God's word. Now, most of us will not cause a scene like that on an airplane or in a public place. Most of us would never probably stand up and read God's word out loud to others unless we were asked to do so. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. And one thing I do know is that even though we don't do those things, it doesn't mean that our hearts are at peace. It doesn't mean that we have no concerns. And there are some of us who try very hard to sleep at night, but we still have problems. Some of us, our digestive systems stay in turmoil all the time. Sometimes we snap at loved ones for no apparent reason. And we sabotage ourselves in our workplace and in our relationships. We're troubled and unhappy people. And the sad thing is that we don't even know why. Years ago, Rabbi Joshua Liebman wrote a best-selling book that was entitled Peace of Mind. After the publication of his book, Rabbi Liebman was swamped with letters from people who were seeking peace. His mail was heavy, his telephone rang constantly. Many people came to see him. He was young and kind-hearted and was a rabbi at 38 years old. He tried to help everyone who contacted him. He died just 3 years later at the age of 41. He just couldn't stand up under the burden that so many people heaped upon him. But before he died, he said, "I am appalled at the multitude of people who have never learned how to empty their minds." The first word that Jesus spoke to his disciples gathered together after his resurrection was the word peace. We read in our lesson from the gospel, when it was evening on that day, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said, "Peace be with you." And after he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord, and Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. Peace be with you." How do we find peace of mind? How do we empty our minds of all the worry, fear, resentment, and pain that living world brings to us. How do we find the peace that Christ promised us? One man said that he had been told the way to achieve inner peace is to finish the things that he had started. He said, "Today I finished 2 bags of potato chips, a box of cookies, and a chocolate cake, and I feel better already." We have a name for it, don't we? We call it comfort food. And now, if all the ladies will be honest about it, chocolate probably appeals to most of us very much. And gentlemen, perhaps a donut with a morning cup of coffee helps relieve your stress. Not your waistline, but your stress. Sometime back, a writer at a website, www.theonion.com, published a fake press release. The press release was touting an imaginary snack food meant to ease what the writer called the hideously bleak emptiness of modern life. The writer described the snack like this: "We're proud to introduce TC McCrispies as the antidote you've been reaching out for. Our tasty new snack cracker will, if only for a few lovely moments, significantly lessen the aching, gnawing angst that haunts your very soul." According to this press release, participants in taste tests testified that the satisfying crunch detracted them from the parade of tears that is life. A fictitious spokesperson summed up the campaign by saying, "We're selling the salty, unctuous illusion of happiness." And of course, it is an illusion. Peace is not found in snack food or a chemical, drugs, alcohol, but it's an inferior right to chemically induce peace of mind. Very fleeting. Jesus said, "Peace be with you." But how and where do we find that peace? For many of us, peace will come only when we come to grips with our past. Many of us are haunted by guilt, resentments, past failures.